it's a bit of an anomaly within the collection. It's actually the only mammal in the collection here. And we don't quite know where it came from. There's very little information that comes with the specimen. So actually tying down what species it is might give us a little bit of a clue perhaps as to where and when it might have come to the collection. Was it actually one of Linnaeus's specimens? The note that's with the specimen is a bit ambiguous about precisely which species it is. My name's Stephanie West. I'm UK Biodiversity Training Manager for the Angela Marmont Centre over in the Natural History Museum. There's five species of long-eared bat in Europe, three of which are very restricted in terms of their range, two of which are found in both Britain and in Sweden. And we know that Linnaeus named one of those species the grey long-eared, Placotus auritus. We're looking at the bat to try and tie down exactly which species it is. At the end of the 1600s, or mid to end of the 1600s, bats are typically being classified in with the birds, as we can see here in this text from Poland, with beautiful illustrations of bats, including suckling bats as well, but they're very much grouped in with the birds as flying animals. It's not until John Ray that bats become classified within what he called the quadrupedia, the four-footed animals. And this copy of Ray here is Linnaeus's copy. It was produced in 1693, and Linnaeus appears to have acquired it in 1734. And the lovely thing with this text is that Linnaeus has actually added to it. He's added his notes, and he actually refers to specific species that he's named within this text. So he's added notes later on to his copy of Ray. He obviously has some interest in bats, because he even draws us a lovely little drawing of a bat in some of his notes as well. So this is the 1758 copy, and within it we've got the bats classified for the first time within mammals, but Linnaeus is grouping them within the primates. That's something we don't do anymore, but it's not until 20 years later that bats become separated out from the primates. Interestingly, Linnaeus identifies the first false vampire bat from South America within this, but he actually identifies seven separate species, one of which is what he calls Vespertilio auritus, which is what we now know as Placotus auritus, or the brown long-eared bat, which is what we've just identified our bat specimen from the collection as being